Today I have a little story time video for you guys of how a hairstylist fried my hair off. Yes, girl, you heard it right. And if you guys didn't notice, my hair is so much shorter than it was before. And just basically like not as healthy and as long as I once had it. But first I want to thank the people who subscribed to my channel, also liked, commented, you guys are amazing. Anyways, let's get into the videos. I'm gonna talk about this hairstylist that I've seen for over a year. I found her through Instagram, through like hashtags, and she was like doing the most amazing like bleach blonde, high level, high lift blonde. And you know I'm into that kind of stuff. So I was seeing her for over a year, and you know, during the quarantine, like hairstylists and salons were closed like all over the world. And so she started operating from home. And I wanna say it was like last year in July. She basically fried my hair off, girl. It was just like so freaking bad. Fried noodle, freaking chow mein, freaking melted like butter. It was just the most horrible mess. I was getting a bleach and tone. She was retouching my root. And if anyone knows, if you know anything about hair, you can't have the bleach overlap onto the lighter pieces of your hair, because otherwise your hair is just gonna snap off. So I have really naturally dark hair. When she was applying the bleach just to the root, that shit was like swelling so much to a point it was like overlapping and my hair was falling off. I'm not one to talk bad about anyone or like talk about how poor of a job people do. I'm not that kind of person, but in this situation, girl, when you're messing with my hair, I have to talk about it. So anyways, like even when she was like sectioning through my hair, she was like ripping my shit off. Like, girl, I can hear like the crunch, you know what I mean? Like when you section the hair to put the bleach, and girl, she'd like rip the hair apart, and girl, it was just like, I heard the crunching and the ripping. I'm like, bitch, I'm gonna look like Cynthia from the Rugrats pretty soon. Like, so for her privacy, we're gonna give her a fake name. We'll call her Yolanda. So I was like, Yolanda, you know, my hair is falling out, like is that okay? Like it was on the ground. I was like, girl, is that okay? I'm talking like there was clumps. Like I was sitting on her couch like waiting for the bleach to process or whatever. First of all, I forgot to mention, one day she was like round brushing my hair, and if you know, like you round brush, when you round brush like bleach blonde hair, and if you like do it wrong or like you pull too hard or you just like are just so rough with it, that shit's gonna snap off. Because she's so rough with her hands working with my hair, like how I told you she was sectioning it. But anyways, I said like, girl, like it's okay, I leave with my hair wet. When I was leaving with wet hair, she's like, oh girl, like how do you part your hair? And I was like, oh, from like left to right. And she's like, oh no, you should part it the other way. You need to start training your hair because this side is getting too much damage. I was like, okay girl, like fine, that's fine. We can flip it the other way. But when I went home and saw the back of my hair, there was like a piece of freaking hair sticking up on the side. And I was like, bitch, she fried my shit. So the next day I showered and it was just like mush. It was just like melted so bad. I have a freaking patch of hair missing. So I was like, oh, Yolanda, like I'll just wait like a few months and we'll switch to the highlights. We'll switch to highlights so there won't be too much damage. And I know I lost a lot of hair. And first of all, girl, she did not even apologize to me after snapping off my hair. And so I waited 2 months and I was like, let's do like a base color and highlights. And if you guys know me or follow me on Instagram, I had this hairstyle that I did before. It was like a really nice golden honey blonde with like platinum highlights. And so I showed her the photos. I think I might have even told her the formula on like how I used to have it done. Oh my fucking God. 2 months of freaking regrowth. I was there at her house for about 8 hours. I don't even want to talk about how much she charged me, girl. Her pricing was like astronomical for what it was. It was just the most horrible thing in the whole entire world. The base color of like the honey blonde and the platinum highlights, I don't know what in the world she was thinking. She did like this base color and like low lights that were like extremely dark, randomly placed in different parts of my head. It just looks so bad. I'll insert some photos here. I don't even know what that was. Like, what was it? It was like a honey blonde with like dark low lights and like freaking a whole gap of root or whatever the case was. This is probably where I went wrong. I was like, oh girl, I love my hair. It looks great. Like, you know, thank you so much. In the back of my head, when I was at her house, when I had paid her, I was like, this shit looks so fucking bad and horrible. Like, oh my God, I've never had anything like that. Like, you didn't even bring the highlights up close to the root or as close to the root as possible. So I left the house and I was like, oh God, like I told my husband, I was like, oh my God, it just looks so freaking bad. Like, I don't even know what to do. The next day I messaged her and I was like, you know, Yolanda, I am so unhappy with my hair. This is just bad. I lost so much hair. you know, I sent her photos and I was like, girl, like, this is unacceptable. And I asked for a refund and she ended up giving me a refund. So I never talked to her again. Girl blocked me, whatever. After I seen that hairstylist who had bleached my hair into smithereens and did the ugly low lights, I had gone to this other salon and I was like, oh, like, you know, I was thinking about doing like a bleach and tone or like highlights. And they were like, oh, we don't know what to do with your hair. We don't know if it's strong, whatever the case is. We don't know if your hair will be able to handle it. So I was like, I had my in-laws visiting. They're coming in 2 weeks. So they toned it to this ugly ass dark ash blonde witchy hair, which I freaking do not like witchy hair. Like, I just feel like really overly ashy hair just does not do any justice. I love that clean, bright bleach blonde, and that was just like a quick fix me up, if you want to say, just to hold over. Searched again for another girl to possibly fix my hair, and we'll call her Anna. Anna was like the most sweetest girl ever. She was so nice to me. I basically told her like my hair history and what happened with the girl who I seen for over a year. I don't want to go too far back with the story, but we'll just talk with the year. We basically were just trying to fix what she had done. So I was like, oh girl, let's do bleach ups. But girl, when she did my hair too, she was applying the bleach and everything on my hair. Girl was falling. My hair just like broke even more. I lost so much hair to a point where there was like a giant ball. I was like, oh my freaking God. I'll insert a photo here, but basically like there was a big ball on this countertop next to my extensions that I was hoping to, you know, like shade match or whatever, which didn't work out. Basically I had like two hairstylists fry my hair off, and this is like kind of where my hair is at now. I had gotten in touch with my old hairstylist who was doing my hair for years. Love her so much. And she helped fix it. So now I'm basically like on a hair journey just to like get it healthy, get it long again. So hopefully I could start filming more videos. Have you ever gone to a salon and you had like a bad experience, had like a hairstylist fry off your hair, give you something what you didn't want? Just please comment down below. I would love to hear any of your like stories or whatever. At the time, I felt so freaking alone. You know, I know, girl, we're in the middle of a goddamn pandemic, but like, I did not even leave the house for like, I swear to God, 2 weeks. I was like, I'm not leaving the house looking a hot mess. Like, people are gonna look at me weird, you know, and I'm a military spouse. So like, you know, living on base, like, it's just kind of like a small community. And it's just like, I don't want to step out looking a mess, girl. Like, you know, I'm supposed to be like the blonde bombshell kind of deal. But yeah, so like if you guys are thinking about going blonde or bleaching your hair, please do your research. Please find a good hairstylist who wouldn't like melt your shit off, like knows how to do your hair, because it was like the most traumatizing thing ever. Like, this has never happened to me in like my whole entire life ever, and I've been blonde since 2009, so it's just kind of like, I'm so much happier now with my hair. It looks so much better. I'm totally losing daylight right now. I'm trying to film the video since I haven't filmed one in a while, because I know you guys love videos, honey. I don't want it to be too long or too negative or anything like that. I just want to share my story and what had happened to me, and just to let you guys know that like, if you're going through anything, you'll get through it. Please subscribe to my channel and please comment down below. Tell me your story, girl. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Love you guys.